Hello students of 5th standard. Today we are going to start a new chapter from your science textbook. That is nothing but chapter number 3, The Earth and Its Living World. What do you mean by Earth? Earth is nothing but one of the planet in which or on which the life is existing. And living world means where the world where the life is there. So today we are going to see this lesson that is nothing but the earth and its living world. See here from first, on the surface of the earth. Whenever you see on the surface of the earth, see in your textbook, you have given you can say one figure is there in your textbook that is nothing but the spheres of the earth. It is given, see there, lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. Lithosphere means the sphere where the land exists. Hydrosphere means the sphere where the water exists. Atmosphere means it is nothing but where the air exists. And biosphere means where the life exists. That is called as a biosphere. So these are the spheres of the earth. Today we are going to see about this in the detail. See here, on the surface of the earth, we find land in some places. There are some places on where we find the land and water in others. And you can say water in the others. The earth is surrounded by an atmosphere. We know that earth is surrounded by an atmosphere. That is nothing but earth is surrounded by an air. Then see, there are living things on land, in water and in air. So there are living things. Living things means which are having life in them. They are living on, you can say, land, water and in air. The sun, the cause of many natural processes on the earth. Sun is nothing but one of the cause of causing, you can say, many natural processes are caused due to the sun on the earth. Water, land and air constitutes envelope of the earth, namely sea, hydrosphere, lithosphere and atmosphere. These are nothing but they are, you can say, acting as one of the shell or one of the sheet. That is nothing but hydrosphere, lithosphere and atmosphere. The biosphere spreads in all direction. Whenever you see the earth's crust is very hard. Whenever you see the, you can say, shell of the earth, or you can, whenever you observe the earth is very hard. You can say it is mainly made up of rocks. Whenever you dig the earth, you see that there are various types of the, you can say, rocks. So we can say earth is mainly made up of rocks. When we travel in hilly regions, we see layer of, you can say, soil and rocks along road cut. Whenever you see that, whenever there is a, you can say, when we travel in the hilly region, we see the layers of the soil and rock whenever the road is cut. We see grassy expanses of the land, means we see grass somewhere in some places, then sand in some places and other things in the other places. The land is covered with the crops. Whenever we see the land is covered with crops in some places, and in some places it is covered with the forest. In others, sometimes we get to see the deeper layer of soils in which the roots spread. There are, you can say, deeper layer of the soil where the roots of the trees, they are spreading. At others, we see the rocks split apart by the, you can say, roots. Tree roots, due to the tree's roots, there is also, you can say, splitting of the rock. This we have seen in the before this lesson whichever we have taken, there is a withering of the rocks. We have seen there is a splitting of the rocks due to the plants also, that we have seen. There are gentle mountain slopes as well as sheer cliffs of the, you can say, rock. Ghats khadge, we may call it as ghats khadge, we may call it as. All these land features are part of the Earth's lithosphere. These parts, whichever there may be, you can say ghats khadge may be there, where which we call it as a, you can say, cliffs, shears or cliffs of the rocks. These are present on the, you can say, land, and it acts as a lithosphere. Much of the Earth's surface is occupied by water. Whenever you see, most of the Earth's surface is occupied by the water. The lithosphere extends under this water. The land also expands in this water also. See, about a third of the surface of the Earth consists of a land. Whenever you see a third surface of a land, it consists of a land. Vast continuous stretch is nothing but a, you can say, stretch, is called as a continent. The land on Earth is divided into 7 continents. Continents means khanda. They are divided into 7 continents. They are nothing but Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica and Australia. So Asia is one of the, you can say, largest continent, and Australia is the smallest continent of this Earth. Then whatever we are going to see in this, you can say, part, what does it tells us? See there, the land is not enough in all places. Whenever you see, the land is not enough in all places. The unevenness gives different shape to land in different place. They are called as the landforms. In picture above, you can see the landforms like plain, hill and mountain. You can see the various types of the, you can say, spaces there, various types of the parts of the land. They are nothing but, you can say, plain, then river is there, hill lock is there, valley is there, mountain is there, then seashore is there. Various, you can say, these are nothing but a land, you can say, these are the parts of the lithosphere. Then see, two-thirds of the Earth surface is covered with an water. Whenever you see, there is a two-third part which is covered with the water. Most of the water is in the ocean, is in the ocean. Ocean water is, you know, it is very salty. There are 5 oceans that are nothing but Atlantica, Pacific, Arctic, then Southern Ocean and Indian Ocean. So there are 5 oceans on this Earth. The land along the margin of the ocean, the land along the margin of the ocean is called as a coastal region. Then see, water bodies of different shapes, there are various water bodies of different shapes and size. These are formed along the coast. For example, we see, you can say, bay, strait, gulf, creek. These water bodies are, you can say, parts of the ocean. That means काही असा अरुंद पार्ट असू शकतो, काही असा पसरट पार्ट असू शकतो, काही असा एकदम निमोलता पार्ट असा असू शकतो. देन सी, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ गल्फ ऑर क्रीक ऑर अ स्ट्रेट ऑर अ, यू कॅन से, बे. सर्फेस वॉटर, देर आर मेनी स्ट्रीम्स ऑफ द वॉटर विच आर फ्लोईंग ऑन द लँड. देर आर वेरियस टाईप्स ऑफ द स्ट्रीम्स विच आर फ्लोईंग ऑन द, यू कॅन से, लँड. This water is not salty, but it is fresh. This is fresh water. The streams of the water may be rills, brooks, streams or rivers. There may be, you can say, nadi, choti si, you can say, nadi asu shakte, Then see, reels are the smallest and the rivers. Rivers are the biggest. Reels are, you can say, very, you can say smallest. What it is called? Odha. Odha, or you can say odha is very smaller. And you can say the rivers, which is called as a nadi. That is nothing but the very biggest one. Reel, brooks, streams join each other from the rivers. Rivers which join to make, you can say, big rivers are called as a tributaries. That means whenever one or more rivers join together, therefore they are called as a tributaries. In the same places, a river coincides, cascades down a sudden drop. This forms a waterfall. That means whenever the water falls from a higher or greater height, it is called as a waterfall. And the river, it enters into the, you can say, oceans, or flows into the ocean. Next comes the lakes. A water body formed by water collecting naturally is low-lying area of land is called as a lake. So what is lake? Lake is nothing but a one of the water body which is formed by water collecting naturally. This water is collected naturally in a low-lying area of the land. This is called as a lake.